Hello, this is Bill Brown, and this is the Banjo by Ear lesson entitled Rhythms and Changes, Section 1. In this lesson, we will be looking at the basic rhythm patterns for 4-4 time and 3-4 time that are used on the banjo, and we will be looking at the main chords in the key of G and C. From this, we will move into even more advanced rhythm patterns and look at some more chords in these keys as well as other keys, but that will be in Section 2. In Section 1, we will be focusing just on simple 3-4 and 4-4 patterns and the key of G and C. So let's get started. The first thing we will want to do is get tuned up. Here is my first string. Here is my second string. Here is my third string. Here is my fourth string. And here is my fifth string. In this opening lesson, we're going to talk about what we call 1, 4, and 5 chords. And we usually notate these with Roman numerals, like Roman numeral 1, Roman numeral 4, and Roman numeral 5. What these represent are the 1, the 4, and the 5 chord of the key. And if we're in the key of G, G would be our 1 chord. So whatever key you're in, that becomes 1. From there, you go through the alphabet, the musical alphabet, numerically until you get to number 4. So for instance, if G is 1, A would be 2, B would be 3, C would be 4. So my 4 chord in the key of G would be a C chord. My 5 chord, which would come after 4, would be D. So we could play a D chord. And that's our 5 chord in the key of G. So in the key of G, your 1 chord is G. Your 4 chord is C. Your 5 chord is D. We could also use what we would call a 5-7 chord. That would be a D7 in our case, which is real common on the banjo. So in the key of G, 1, 4, 5, and your 5-7 would be a D7 chord. Now what I'm going to do is play through a chord progression in the key of G, and I'll play through a 12-bar progression first. It will have 4 measures of 1, 2 measures of 4, 2 measures of 1, then 2 measures of a 5-7 chord, and then 2 measures of a 1. And I will be using a simple 4-4 time pattern for this, which we will talk about in a moment. I want you to hear this chord progression, and then we'll discuss it. We refer to this pattern as a simple quarter note pattern, which means each of these events are getting one beat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Later, we will be looking at an eighth note pattern, the alternating thumb roll, which you should have learned in any basic course, which is an eighth note pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, where you get two events, but these are quarter notes. 1, 2, 3, 4. What we have here is the thumb pick striking the third string. Then my index and middle will strike the first two strings together. Then the thumb pick will strike the fourth string by itself. And then back to the index and middle, striking fingers 1 and 2. And I'm doing this with a basic G chord, which is open, so there's no fingers down. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's a basic, simple 4-4 time pattern using chords.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.